everybody. I'm Dave Brown here at ringside. We are ready to go with another day of championship wrestling action. We got action for you today, too. Jeff Jarrett is going to be in here just a little bit later on in a single match. We will have Dutch Mantel coming up a bit later on. Also, the Japanese team, Shogun Masamune and Samurai Shinji. And P.Y. Chuhai, Phil Hickerson, is going to be going against Frankie the Thumper Lancaster in our expiration of time match today. That should be a good one. We'll have more to say about that one a little bit later on. Being joined right now by promoter Eddie Marlin. Eddie, welcome. Good to have you here.
Thank you, Dave.
Something interesting occurred in the CWA this week, and I want to get your comments on it because it involves some championship belts, and that involved the stud stable.
Right. It's a very important thing that happened. I got a call from Jimmy Golden Tuesday morning, and Jimmy informed me that he and Robert Fuller, the stud stable, had major differences. And he would no longer defend the tag titles with Robert Fuller. Mm-hmm. So naturally that left the belts up for grabs. So that gave the promotion an opportunity to put together a great tournament. And you know, when you have a tournament for those belts, you get calls from all over, everywhere. Jimmy Valiant called, Tommy Rich, a bunch of names is called. Also, we've got Jeff Jarrett's going to have a partner. Robert Fuller, of course, will get a new partner. It's just great tag teams have all signed up for this tournament.
All right, so the tournament's coming up. The CWA tag champions will be decided since the belts are now vacant. So One night tournament,
we'll have new champions.
Looking forward to it. Ought to be tremendous matches for that coming up, because with those belts on the line, that's always
a big prize.
Yeah, yes, indeed. We're going to be back. We got big action coming up here, and we'll be back to get it started for you in just a moment. Now he's been talking to the crowd. Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Brown.
What are you doing here?
I'm sorry.
We got rid of you last week.
I had the same problem that I had last week with your airport here. This is a matchbox airport, a little 10-cent operation. I've been circling the tower for 30 minutes. Can't you do something with this airport?
Well, I don't think it's the airport. I think maybe somebody just doesn't want you here, and we're included in
that. Well, I can tell you,
Ronnie P. Gossett IV, we thought we were rich.
You won't have this problem next week, because I will be here on Friday. I will stay over where I can open the show for all my adoring fans.
Well, don't do us any additional favors, please.
Could you move down a little bit?
I'm not going to move anywhere. I'm going to sit right here. If you're going to sit here, please don't make as much noise as you did last week. We got to get this match underway. Yeah, matter of fact, speaking of last week, I want to show everybody this. Most of you have already seen it. Just a reminder of why maybe you might reconsider sitting here. Take a look at what happened last week.
What? What are you
going to
show? What are you talking about?
I only had any eggs. See, that's what it would be like. Hey, wait a minute.
You don't show that piece of trash about me, because my attorney, F. Lee Babcock, will be in touch with you, wimp. And I'm tired of you trying to tear me down. That idiot deliberately did that to try and sabotage me.
Now he's just putting you in your place.
He's not putting me anywhere.
Speaking of your place, if you're going to stay here, just please sit and stay over there if you don't mind.
Put the camera in here.
See if we can get... Yeah, hear the music. Here comes Jeff Jarrett.
There he is.
We've got a one call, 10-minute, 5-minute match coming up here. Jeff Jarrett going against Keith Eric. Eric out of Memphis, Tennessee, weighs in at about 220 pounds.
All the way to open the card. Wimpy Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah.
Wimpy pretty boy Jeff Jarrett.
Yeah. I don't understand that too much, because I happen to know, I thought you and Jeff Jarrett used to be friends.
You got the right word. We used to be friends before I found out what a real wimp he was. So look, like I said last week, he's the son of Jerry Jarrett. That's the kiss of death. Jeff's got some potential, very little.
Potential? He's one of the top wrestlers in the country.
I said he had some potential. I don't stretch it.
Well, there's Keith Eric. Jeff Jarrett has been in total control of the match so far. He grabs Keith by the left arm. Look at him wrap it up a couple of times. Steps under, hooks him.
Looks like
the mat.
He used the tights on that. Why don't you call it like it is?
Use the tights. Just use that arm and force him down to the mat. Eric tried to complain he had his hair pulled.
He certainly did.
Yeah, he did.
Are you blind? Could you not see this?
I saw exactly what happened. He
evidently
used the
not.
Arm to take him down.
Jeff's not as strong as that guy. He couldn't have just taken him down.
Referee is there checking to see if Eric's shoulders are both on the mat. Eric's left shoulder was not flat on the mat, so the referee did not start the count. There's a shoulder butt by Eric.
Very good shoulder block.
Down to the mat he goes. Nice move by Jeff Jarrett.
He's lucking up again.
Luck to it. That's just athletic ability.
He has no athletic ability. That boy has been in the dark ever since he started in the wrestling business, and you can credit his illiterate father, Jerry Jarrett, with what he is today. Nothing. The best thing for that boy to do is change his name.
I think millions of wrestling fans will disagree with you on that. Eric with the arm hammered up behind the back.
So.
Jeff reverses it. He gets the hammer on Eric. They're reversing each other back and forth here. Keith Eric with the advantage right now. We're 2 minutes into the action.
Time until Jeff Jarrett will submit. He'll give it up.
He does not give it up. Instead, he reverses
just
Eric.
Just a matter of time. Terrific forearm smashes. Reversal.
Eric reversed him into the turnbuckles. Look at Jeff flip him out of the corner. What a move.
Look at Calhoun. Look at Calhoun. That was a fast count if I ever saw one. Fast count.
He counted one, two, three.
Yeah,
that's
one,
just
two,
the way
three.
You're supposed to do it. And Jeff Jarrett walks out of here to the congratulations of the fans. He has himself a victory here in this match against Keith Eric today. Eric is steamed, and you are too, but Jarrett looked mighty good as he got the win.
When he does something like that, it's all right. Little Jeffy Jarrett, that's fine.
2 minutes.
He didn't win that match.
He did win the match. Two minutes, 26 seconds. We'll be back in just a moment.
Everyone, I'm Roger Webb with Championship Wrestling. We want to remind you that coming to you on Thursday, April 6th, we're going to be in Henryville, Indiana. We'll be at the high school there. Then on Evansville, we're going to be in Evansville Wednesday, March 22nd, and what an event that's going to be. One night, seven-match tournament for the CWA Tag Team titles. Before the night's over, we're going to have new CWA Tag Champions.
That's right, Roger. We got more than payback for you, Imperial Dynasty. We've got the tag team titles to fight for, and me and Tracy intend to go all the way.
Well, this is a big night in Evansville. One-night tournament for the CWA tag team titles. When you're a tag team, that's what it's all about. This is what we train for. And the Japanese team, you're tough guys, you're a tough team, but we're coming right through you. And I guarantee you, in Evansville, you're looking at the new CWA tag team champion.
That's going to be the first big match of this tournament. And Jeff, right after that, you've got Tommy Reach and P.Y. Chu Hai.
That's right, Roger. You know, this Wednesday night coming up, you said, is the tag tournament. And these belts, they evolved from the old Southern belts, and there was a lot of great champions. The Greens, the Von Brauners, Eddie Marlin and Tommy Gilbert, the Fargos. So there's been a lot of great champions come down the road. And there's going to be a new one this Wednesday night. And I've got a partner, Brian Lee, and last week, Roger, we came as close as you can get to holding those belts. And I feel like that me and Brian are the champions. But we've got a tough first-round match with P.Y. Chu Hai and Tommy Rich. And Tommy Rich, I've heard some things he's been saying, and he is pointing his finger right at me. But guys, me and Brian Lee are coming for one thing and one thing only, and that's to walk out of that Evansville Coliseum with the belts around our waist. You know, if we win the first match, we might end up having to wrestle Tracy. We don't know, but that's one thing about a tournament. You don't know who you're going to wrestle, and I can't wait to get there Wednesday night because me and Brian are going to give it everything we got.
Good luck to you, Jeff. Don't forget, that's Wednesday, March 22nd, Evansville, Indiana. What a great match. We're going to have a new CWA Tag Team Champion.
rough and ready in the ring. Boss Winters tries again. He's wandering around talking to the crowd.
Rough and ready, an outstanding team, Dave. An outstanding team. Be sure you put that in there. Give these boys credit.
Speaking of outstanding team, here they come right here. The Mason-Dixon connection. Tracy Smothers and John Paul.
Oh, my goodness. We've got that little trucking line again. You know the thing about Tracy Smothers, Dave Brown, he started out in the wrestling business. That's right. That's right.
Exactly. Rough and ready. Jump John Paul and Tracy Smothers from behind.
They just should have been ready to start the match.
The bell had not sounded, and they jumped him anyway. But it doesn't take long. Look at this. Tracy Smothers chasing Reddy and John Paul on his rope.
Look at this illegal maneuver right there.
Run them together out there.
It certainly is. Certainly is. You know, Tracy Smothers, you never know what boy is going to show up. He's been Tracy Smothers, the Southern boy, the wild-eyed Southern boy. And now he is with John Paul, the Pop Gun, or whatever he is.
They're the Mesa-Dixon connection.
Oh, is that
That's what
they are?
Look
well,
at this.
Got several other names.
Powers it down to the mat. It covers one. Doesn't get the three count. He
you
got
notice
it for
how
one.
Slow Calhoun is. I don't want to say that he's prejudiced, but when a certain team is in there, he takes his time with the count.
Off the top rope, Tracy
completely
Smothers with
illegal,
the feet.
Completely illegal.
He kicked him and dropped him right down
he
to the mat.
He certainly did.
Hey, don't forget, we got a big match coming up a little bit later on as P.Y. Chuhai, Phil Hickerson, is going to be going against Frankie the Thumper Lancaster. Grudge match here.
Look at it.
There was a breakup during a tag team match
on.
During the week. Tojo Yamamoto got involved, and Frankie said, I want a return match, and we've got it for you right here on Championship Wrestling on television today.
Look at John Paul, a complete idiot. He doesn't have a clue as to what's going on.
John Paul takes the tag. He's paying very close attention to what's happening. He's up on the middle rope. Tracy holds it. He springs over. Rough
double
and ready.
Teaming. You see all this double teaming, Dave Brown? You never say a word about this double teaming.
That was one member tagged the other, and as soon
but
as he hit
get
them out, he
the
turned
count.
And
he
left.
He stayed right in there. He certainly does.
Tracy Smothers raked across the face.
I certainly
by
do.
Rough.
And it will be changed, I can assure you.
High sidekick by Tracy Smothers. He covers one, two, hit
Look
three.
At this.
He got him.
Look at this. You call that fair. Do you honestly call that fair?
I certainly do. And there are the hands raised. John Paul, Tracy Smothers get a victory over Ruff and Reddy here today.
Give me a break.
Boy, Boss Winters is steamed. He's always
steamed. I don't blame
steamed.
Him for being steamed.
Why?
I don't blame him at all.
On
the That's exactly right.
Watching a different match there, boys.
Well, evidently, we're not watching the same one you are.
Well, anyway, we've got the referee's
week.
Decision, and that
same
is
problem
that,
with
the Mason-Dixon connection has the victory.
They
the time on it.
Yeah, they
two
have
minutes,
it. They didn't
nine
win it.
Seconds. We had a problem that developed during the week in the CWA that we talked about a little bit earlier, and I want to kind of give them a chance to say their piece about it, at least Robert Fuller, the stud stable. It looks like things are certainly coming apart for the stud stable here.
Dave Brown,
here
I'll help this
right.
interview because I need to talk to
I
him.
Think I can take care of it, Mr. Gossett, if you don't mind.
You don't have a compassionate bone in your body. There's nothing you can do about this. I'll handle this interview
you know,
right
I
here.
You don't have
Robert.
Any compassion at all for these guys right here,
I've
so
known you
do
you
it.
For
go ahead.
Many years, Robert. You're one of the most compassionate men in this business. And when you hurt, I hurt. And I hate to see you this upset, Robert.
Well, you know, I've fallen on hard times. That, in particular, my whole stable's fallen on hard times. As you know, you've been watching Ronnie for a sucks.
Why don't y'all shut up out there and listen to me?
Hold it down.
As you know,
here.
Ron, I'm not going to get no respect out here in the first
no.
place. But what I'm going to say, I'm going to say it very quickly and get it out of the way. Gary Young and Cactus Jack, one of the first guys in my stable that came down the line here, and it didn't work out. Those boys went their own way. Then I hired a black moron. I'm talking about Brickhouse Brown. And I had to take care of his baby and send him on down the road. And then, as you know, I know it's
Robert,
not my fault.
That is
Sylvia.
Not your fault.
I know it's not my fault.
Not
but
at all.
I went on even further. I got Phil Hickerson, and I sent Phil over to Japan to make him a lot of money, and he came back thinking he's a Japanese. And that's the end of Phil Hickerson, far as I'm concerned.
Robert, don't ever feel that's your fault.
That's all right. I don't feel it's my fault, but let me finish then. Then I had this big Sidney Vicious come in here. What a big, tough guy I figure is going to make me a lot of money, and I had to knock him out myself. You think that ain't hard times, Buster? And then right down to the last leg of it, my own family, a fallout with my cousin Jimmy Golden, which caused us to have to vacate our beloved belts. And when I say beloved belt, that belt means so much to me, I had my own picture put in the front of it. And that's where it's going to stay, far as that goes. But you know something? Let me just get my glasses out here, because I want the people to know something. As hard as times get for the stud, baby, the sun shines for me night and day.
That's right.
This is what's about to happen, Ronnie Gossett. In every state of the United States, there's at least one good man, one stud, if you know what I'm talking about.
That's
right,
exactly
here in the state of Tennessee, I am the man. No. I am your man. And let's tell it like it is, because what I'm about to do is I'm about to start a standard in wrestling of the very best, Ronnie Gossett. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hire that stud from every state of the United States. And I'm going to start with the biggest state in the United States. I'm talking about Texas, baby. I'm bringing the man into my stable. I want to bring him out here right now if I can, because what we're going to do is put together the greatest stable of all time. I want the man. I want the toughest guy to ever walk down a Texas street, Dutch Mantell, if he wanted to come on out.
He's a new man. Come on, you idiot. Give him a hand.
We may worship him.
This is going to be a great event.
Oh, yeah. It certainly is.
Let me say, it is a great day in my life, Mr. Fuller, and you too, Miss Lovely Sylvia, to be associated with one of the finest wrestling organizations in the country today. And Rob, I want you to know, with our ability and our brains, we cannot be stopped. We're going to take over and dominate wrestling, not only the rest of the 80s, but well into the 90s. Do you understand what I'm talking about? And I want everybody in the back.
Shut up. Let me tell you exactly the way it is now. This is what's going to happen. That some of you lucky ones out there are going to get the opportunity to join the stud stable. And there's going to be two sides to it, baby. That's either you're with us or you're against us. And if you're against us, that means the stud stable that is in existence is going to put you out of existence, baby. And you're going to be understanding that. You will get an offer if you're worth it, and you'll accept that offer, or it'll be the worst thing you ever did in your life as a mistake. And on the other hand now, let me say, as sure as you see Dutch Mantell here is the CWA heavyweight champion, that when we acquire our belts, we're going to put them belts on the line to anybody, anywhere, anytime, baby, because we're going to have an open door on all of our tag belts, on our single belts, on all of our belts, because we want this wrestling to be exciting. And we want our
belts. Always rises to the top. The cream to the top. This is not, this is not your time. This is their time. This is their interview, kid.
No, I didn't ask you to talk. You just sit there and hold the microphone. Robert Fuller, I sat back there, and you know, we never have seen eye to eye on anything. But I sat back there, and I was just waiting for you to say those few words. That's right, you got a new company. You got a new company. You got a new champion. And you said that you got an open door policy, that you'll put your belt on the line anywhere, any place. And that's one thing we see eye to eye on. Now, if you're going to back up your big mouth that you always run, then put your money where your mouth is and put your champion in the ring right here today, and I'll face him. Because that's, I've dreamed of holding that belt, and I'd like a shot. Wait just a minute, Jarrett. I would get in the ring with you today, but, Rob, I didn't come prepared to wrestle.
Come on.
I'll tell you what, if this man was ready to wrestle, he'd put his title up to you right now. He just don't have his stuff on him.
A few minutes, put the belt up. We'll wrestle. We'll go to a break and we'll have a match.
Boy, speak up if you want to be heard around here. Hey, can he change the television or what?
You think just because you're a jet, you can do anything?
Open door policy. Will Fuller back up your big mouth and put that belt on the line?
Okay, you want to wrestle me?
Put the belt up.
Get the ring right there.
Get yourself dressed up, baby. Put that belt up. Put it up, Doc.
Hey, Randy, he don't stand a chance.
Are you going to put that title up?
Yes, the title's going up. The title's going up on TV.
Okay, Dave, we'll take a break. We'll come. You're not dressed to run.
No,
you give me a few minutes.
It certainly is.
Give me a
time
away. The people want to see me. Give me a few minutes, Dave.
Going to make it a title match. Going to make it a title match.
Okay, fans, the title match, the one you've waited for.
We'll take a break.
Well, Jeff Jarrett has really, he stepped in it this time.
We're going to take a break. Dutch Mantell will get ready, and we'll be back here, and we'll have the championship match for you in just a couple of minutes. Stand by. We'll be back.
Hello, everyone. I'm Roger Webb with Championship Wrestling. We want to remind you that coming to you on Thursday, April 6th, we're going to be in Henryville, Indiana. We'll be at the high school. Evansville, Indiana, folks, look out. We're coming to you on Wednesday, March 22nd, a one-night, seven-match tournament. And before we leave, we're going to have new CWA Tag Team Champions. Regular prices, too. We're going to have matches like Shogun and Samurai versus a Mason-Dixon connection. Bill Dundee and Todd Morton will be going against Dutch Mantell and the Master of Pain. Jeff Jarrett and Brian Lee going against Tommy Raich and P.Y. Chuhai. And the first round match, Action Jackson, Robert Fuller with Sylvia going against Jed Grundy and Jungle Jim. Coming your way now in Evansville, Indiana, on Wednesday, March 22nd, regular prices. This is for the new CWA Tag Team Championship. Now, don't you forget now, you folks in Henryville, we're going to be there Thursday, April 6th at the high school. Don't forget, Evansville, Wednesday, March 22nd for the big championship match.
Dave Brown here at ringside.
You know, Dave Brown,
I've been joined by Ronnie Gossett, the fourth.
I've had a lot of cards and letters and telegrams this week, and I want to tell you one thing. Despite all that, I will be here as your host from now on of Championship Wrestling.
I can imagine. Hey, there's the champion right there, Dutch Mantell,
that
with Robert Fuller.
Champion.
And it looks like he is just about ready to go. Here comes the challenger.
Oh, my goodness. This should be short-lived.
This is going to be a championship match. The CWA heavyweight title is on the line. You've got a championship match right here today.
David and Goliath.
Introducing the challenger. At 207 pounds from Hendersonville, Tennessee, Jeff Jarrett. And the champion, current holder of the CWA heavyweight title, from Oil Trough, Texas, Dutch Mantell. CWA heavyweight belt is on the line. Robert Fuller is acting as manager to Dutch Mantell. He's in the corner. The referee says, let's get this one going, and the championship match is in progress.
You know what these morons don't know, Davey Brown, is that Dutch Mantell has beaten just about everybody in professional wrestling. He's beaten Jerry the Blob Lawler. He's even beaten the Macho Man. And you think a punk like Jeff Jarrett stands a chance against Dutch Mantell? Give me a break.
Jeff Jarrett has held the championship belt or two himself. He was Rookie of the Year his first year in wrestling. He's a former high school athlete.
Richard Nixon used to be president. We're talking about today, pal.
Jeff Jarrett takes Dutch Mantell down to the mat, bars the left arm. Mantell up on one knee, but Jeff holds on. This match, by the way, a special TV time limit on the championship match. Usually on championship matches, of course, there's the mandatory one-fall 60-minute time limit.
Oh, nice. There's a fist. You didn't open your mouth about the fist, Davey Brown.
That was a right fist. I'll give you that. Nice uppercut.
Uppercut.
As he let Dutch Mantell have
it. I call it a blatant fist.
Jeff Jarrett waiting, center of the ring. Dutch Mantell hanging back, complaining to the referee about something. I don't know what.
Dutch Mantell's got two people to beat. He's got that retarded Calhoun and that retarded Jeff Jarrett.
Headlock by Dutch Mantell. He wraps up on it. He's got
it
tight.
If he had any sense, he'd submit on this headlock.
Jeff Jarrett. You know, Jeff, we haven't mentioned at somewhat of a disadvantage. He has already wrestled a match just a few minutes ago. This is his second match of the day.
Well, he shouldn't have come out here and talked about how good he was. He was the one made the challenge.
I Well, he did make the challenge.
He certainly did.
Dutch Mantell and Robert Fuller. I think maybe it was Fuller, really, that accepted more than Mantell.
He's left that little alligator mouth overload that Jaybird behind. That's exactly what he's done.
Well, it could have been Robert Fuller that did that, you know. Well, remains to be seen.
Robert Fuller is a gentleman. Robert Fuller is a scholar.
Dutch Mantell out of the ring. He's frustrated by Jeff Jarrett.
That's
the count's at four, five.
Around.
Referee counting on him. That's seven. Dutch Mantell rolls back into the ring. A 10 count, and he would have been counted out of the match. Jeff Jarrett. Oh, got raked across the eyes. Mantell, terrific move.
Dutch Mantell.
Mantell poked him in the eyes with his fingers. Jeff hooks him down.
Hooks the tights. He's got the tights.
He only got a two count. Mantell was going to pick Jeff up and body slam him. He was setting himself, but Jeff had anticipated the move and hooked him down. Almost
Jeff
got the three count on.
Not smart enough to anticipate anything.
Well, anyone who was watching closely saw exactly what happened right there. Jeff Jarrett now takes that left arm of Dutch Mantell and wraps it up.
Be just a matter of time till Jeff Jarrett will be nothing more than a fleeting page of history.
Jeff Jarrett may walk out of here the new CWA heavyweight champion, too. Don't forget that.
Would you like to make a wager?
No, I don't wager. But, there's a cover. One, two. Almost. So close, Jeff Jarrett was
so
to
close.
A three count.
But yet so far away.
Jeff Jarrett almost had a Dutch Mantell. Can't believe it. What's going on, says Mantell. This was supposed to be easy.
Oh, it will be easy. I have no doubts about Dutch Mantell's ability to beat quippy Jeff Jarrett.
Mantell stalking around. Came out of the corner. Jeff forces him back into the turnbuckle. Clean break, says the referee. Jeff backs away, both hands in the air, nice and clean. Mantell going to the tight.
He's
you
not
see
going
him.
To the tight.
You see him.
He's
right
adjusting
there.
The waistband. He's adjusting the waistband.
Yeah. See if he pulls a set of brass knucks or a chain out of there.
A scientific wrestler like Dutch Mantell doesn't resort to those kind of tactics. He doesn't need to.
Mantell now playing around with the knee pad.
He's continuing
and
to
the tights.
The waistband of the tights.
Now he's got some kind of foreign object.
Doesn't have anything.
I tell you what, this is kind of an impromptu match here. It was not scheduled at the beginning of the day as a championship match. We're going to have to take a break. We'll continue the tape rolling. If anything happens, we'll show you when you get back. If you miss anything, you'll see it.
We'll
when we
keep
come
it
back.
Rolling so you can see Jeff Jarrett get beat.
Let's take the break and we'll be back to continue the match in a moment. A heavyweight title match continues. Dutch Mantell, the champion, against challenger Jeff Jarrett. You see Mantell out of the ring here. What you missed while we were away with commercial was not really a whole lot.
I want you to look at this.
Look at this,
that
Jeff Jarrett.
Illegal.
Really popping Dutch Mantell. Now here comes Robert.
Tried to stay out of this thing long as I could, but you see the crowd, baby.
Whoa.
I'm pulling for their hero, baby. I'm gonna be out here pulling for mine.
Jeff Jarrett missed the drop kick.
Exactly where you should be, Robert. I can assure you, though.
Let's talk it up about that new Texas stud in there, baby. Let's hear it about the champion, Dutch Mantell. Tell him about it.
I started to tell
Dutch
you while
Mantell
we were waiting for commercial,
no
you didn't really miss too much.
He has
Mantell,
done it all.
Mantell put it to a vote.
To
he was the most
Jeff
popular
Jarrett.
Wrestler. And the crowd, I think you know who they voted for with their applause.
He's no stranger to the wrestling world.
All right, guys, hey, man, let's tell him about a real wrestling man now, huh? Let's tell him about that new Texas stud.
Yeah, very impressive. Very impressive.
Dutch Mantell, the newest member of the stud stable, as he joined earlier today.
A
Robert Fuller.
Smash.
Robert Fuller very proud of that fact. Sylvia out here.
He certainly needs help.
Oh, look out. Clothesline by Dutch Mantel.
Move by Dutch Mantel. I doubt if that kid will be able to get back into the ring. That's it. Mantel out of it.
Mantel back in the ring. Jeff Jarrett down on the floor out here. Up, right.
Help him in, Robert. Help him in.
Help him in with a light fist. Jeff knocks it down.
Now you call that fair?
Sure, I call it fair. Fuller got no business interfering here. Jeff off the top rope, presses Mantel down to...
He didn't win that belt.
As he was coming after Jeff with a chair, Smothers and John Paul out to congratulate him and kind of even it up here.
He did not win that belt.
He won it fair and square right up there in the middle of the ring after Fuller tried to go after him down here on the floor.
Dutch Mantel was raped. He didn't lose that belt.
Jeff Jarrett pinned Dutch Mantel fair and square in the ring and is the brand new CWA champion. Robert Fuller had no business getting involved, and you know it, and all the wrestling fans know it. He should have stayed out of it altogether.
This will be under investigation. I assure you of that.
Investigate all you want. We've got a new CWA heavyweight champion in Jeff Jarrett.
He didn't win anything.
We'll take time and be back in a moment.
He didn't win anything.
I'm Roger Webb with Championship Wrestling. We want to remind you that we're going to be in Henryville, Indiana at the high school on Thursday, April 6th with a tremendous card. Evansville, Indiana people, look out for this match. Our matches on Wednesday, March 22nd, one-night, seven-match tournament for new CWA Tag Team Champions. Some of the people that will be in the ring in the first round match include Action Jackson, Robert Fuller with Sylvia, going against Jed Grundy and Jungle Jim. You're going to see Bill Dundee with Todd Morton versus Dutch Mantel, the Master of Pain. And look out for Shogun Samurai. They're going to be going against the Mason-Dixon Connection.
My Imperial Dynasty, Shogun and Samurai, we're going to be the CWA Tag Team Champions. John Paul, Tracy Smothers, my boy is going to crucify you and beat you bad.
Oi!
Banzai!
Don't you forget, too, another great match. Jeff Jarrett, Brian Lee, they're going to be in the ring with Tommy Rich and P.Y. Chuhai. Tommy Rich and P.Y. Chuhai, they had this to say.
Lord and mercy, look at here, P.Y. Chuhai, the famous one. Wildfire, together as a tag team. I got one thing to say, and one thing I want everybody to hear. All you people sitting out there, take a good look at Jeff Jarrett. If you want your kid to grow up like that, you better care him somewhere.
Oh, they say, together again, reunited. P.Y. Chuhai, we're going to be there. Jeff Jarrett, Brian Lee, you better bring some kung fu with you, baby.
All this Wednesday, March 22nd, Evansville, Indiana, regular prices. Don't miss it. A new CWA Tag Team Champion.
Jimmy Golden has left the stud stable. As a result, the CWA tag team titles are vacant. One-night tournament coming up to determine the new champions. And here are some highlights of some of the teams that will be participating.
Thank you.
CWA tag team titles that'll all be decided in that one night tournament. In the ring right now, Mr. Thompson, the Freezer, is up there with his partner Chris Frazier. Thompson out of Arkansas, Chris Frazier out of Mississippi, and come roaring into the ring. Action Jackson goes after him. Action Jackson and the Master of Pain. Boy, they wasted no time. They grab Thompson, throw him out of the ring. Chris Frazier fired into the ropes. Action Jackson with the upper arm. There's a tag. Jackson on the Master of Pain. You know, Dutch Mantell is usually out with the Master of Pain. I suppose since he lost his championship, he's not going to be around here today while the Master of Pain is.
Dutch Mantell did not lose his championship. You know, Dave Brown, you and Lance Russell, what you know about professional wrestling, you could put on a postage stamp. Jeff Jarrett stole the belt. Do you understand what I said? Stole the belt.
If you were watching earlier and saw the match, you know exactly what happened. Jeff Jarrett stole nothing. He won it fair and square.
Not
he is
only
the new CWA
the belt,
champion.
He lacerated Robert Fuller, a true gentleman in professional wrestling. And you call that fair?
I call that good enough for him. He never should have gotten involved to begin with. He involved himself in the match from outside. He had no business being there. Count is three.
The fork in that guy. He's done.
Action Jackson gets the pin on Chris Frazier. Come on, break it up, Jackson. You've won the match. It's over. Action Jackson and the Master of Pain, wasting no time. 1:08 the time on it as they defeat Chris Frazier and William the Freezer Thompson. Now, come on, the match is over. They throw Thompson and Frazier.
It was over before they even got in the ring.
Out of the ring again.
Scientific wrestling. Good scientific wrestling.
Too much power, that's what it was.
You can tell Frazier certainly didn't miss many meals. Look at him, he looks horrible, out of shape.
Thompson and Frazier, neither one of them having a good day here today against the huge team of Master of Pain and Action Jackson.
They probably went to the Bill Dundee School of Self-Defense.
Finally, Jackson and Master of Pain leave here. Yeah, here he comes back. Here comes Robert Fuller. All right.
It's going to be too pleasant here, baby, but I'll tell you what. I got Dutch Mantell, I guess, into a little bit of trouble. I owe him something, baby. And I'm telling you, Dutch, you're going to be just like a brother to me. First man of the stud stable, I'm going to say that, baby. You are a stud. What I'm holding in my hand right here happens to be a check, baby. Take a close look at it.
$20,000.
It's $20,000. It comes straight out of my bank account. You notice that top line up there has not been signed. There's not a man's name on it. But the man's name that goes right in there is the man that's going to finish that punk Jeff Jarrett from wrestling in my beloved profession. I'm going to tell you something, boy. You busted me your lifetime. It's not only going to be the stud itself that's going to be coming after your tail. It's going to be everybody I hire. And I'm going to promise you something. I'm going to hire the toughest men throughout the country to put him away. Watching this television, you don't have to wrestle, Daddy. Collect this $20,000. Put that punk out of my profession.
Well, I'm going to get my back. It couldn't happen again in a million years. Jeff Jarrett will not beat me. It's a complete truth. But Robert has got a check for $20,000, and I intend to do three things. I intend to get the $20,000, get my belt back at a tag team tournament, me and the Master of Pain, or Robert Fuller and Action Jackson. They're going to end up with the tag team belts. I'm getting out of here. I'm sick and tired of you here.
Hasn't been a good week for the stud stable.
Can you take a look out here? Get a close-up look, baby. So right underneath that pretty face you see in that picture, that's my face. This is my belt. And I'm going to guarantee you one thing. Somebody's going to earn $20,000, and it's going to be soon because Jarrett's going down and myself and Action Jackson. That's the only thing that's going to change is Jimmy Golden's picture's coming out and Action Jackson's going in because this is my beloved belt and it's going to stay that way.
Well, you win it at the tag team tournament, not standing here talking about it. As I said, it's been a bad week for the stud stable. We'll see if their luck continues the way it has been going, which is not good at all.
They'll be back around our waist Monday night.
We're going to take care of them for whoever wins them in the tag team tournament. Now, if you take... $20,000 check. He's put a bounty on Jeff Jarrett's head.
You know, for $20,000, Ronnie P. Gossett IV may just throw my hat in the ring after Jeffy Jarrett.
Yeah, well, good luck to you on that. Let me tell you, Jeff, I don't think Jeff Jarrett is all that worried, I got to tell you. He has the belt.
He's shaking in his boots.
Coming in right now, the Imperial One, Tojo Yamamoto, P.Y. Chuhai is with him. Chuhai steps into the ring. This has the makings of a tremendous match. A grudge is at stake here. There was a tag team action earlier in the week, and Tojo got involved in the match against Frankie Lancaster. And Lancaster said, I want a match with P.Y. Chuhai. Well, the promoters are bringing it to you right now. Here he comes. Frankie the Thumper Lancaster coming in. He's out of Tampa, Florida. P.Y. Chuhai, Phil Hickerson out of Jackson, Tennessee. In his corner with a kendo stick, Tojo Yamamoto. The jacket, the Japanese jacket that P.Y. Chuhai has comes off. And here we go.
Phil Hickerson has long been one of the toughest men in this business. He should have no problem with this Thumper, Plumper, what's his name?
Frankie the Thumper Lancaster. Frankie the Thumper Lancaster, former member of the Stud Stable. And we have really been impressed with his physical ability, his wrestling moves. He's an excellent wrestler. The fans just haven't been very happy at all that he's been in the Stud Stable and all the things that means. He's no longer in the stable.
That's good for the Stud Stable.
It's good for Frankie Lancaster, let me tell you. P.Y. Chuhai, Phil Hickerson with the top wrist lock. Lancaster takes his feet out from under him and gets that 289 pounds down on the mat instead of standing on his feet. Tojo Yamamoto, you can see him there yelling at the referee, distracting him. Frankie Lancaster retaining control. Well, quite a day here. We've got a new CWA heavyweight champion.
We do not have a new CWA heavyweight champion.
We certainly
do.
He's Jeff Jarrett. Frankie Lancaster trying to defeat big P.Y. Chuhai Phil Hickerson here. And coming up, we've got that one-night CWA tag team tournament in which the winners will be crowned CWA tag champions at the end of the night. This is a set of belts that has an incredible history. I mean, it goes back to the Von Brauners. Some of you wrestling fans may remember the Von Brauners who held the old Southern tag belts. These belts are descended from those.
Long before that.
Eddie Marlin, Tommy Gilbert were holders. Jim White and Jerry Lawler. The Greens, Al and Don Green, remember them? All former holders of these very historically important belts, which are going to be on the line in this upcoming one-night tournament. Not only that, Ronnie P. Gossett IV, if you have these CWA heavyweight belts, or CWA tag belts, that makes you a top contender for the world tag title, too.
That's exactly right. That's one of the most prestigious tag belts in the country. But I'll tell you what, for my money, I'm betting on Robert Fuller and Action Jackson.
Well, it remains to be seen. A lot of top-name teams are involved. Tojo and a goofy kendo stick.
He just gave him a tap to wake him up.
For what? He's not supposed to be involved. He's supposed to manage, not get involved in the match.
Not involved.
2 minutes, 50 seconds gone in this one. P.Y. Chuhai raking his fingernails across the back. A Frankie the Thumper Lancaster. Here comes Lancaster.
Using a fist.
Good drop kick by Lancaster. He can get off his feet into the air. Hickerson coming back with that taped right hand.
You know, Hickerson and I are on the same type of training. We both train the same way. That's why we look as good as we look.
Yeah, I don't know that I need to comment on that. Count of two for P.Y. Chuhai. Frankie Lancaster ducks under a forearm and presses him down to the mat. One. Count of one is all he gets. Hickerson breaks it at that point.
We definitely need to do something about what's his name, Jerry Calhoun.
Look at Lancaster take him off his feet again. Tojo was up on the apron. The referee didn't see it, though. He was in position to start the count. Lancaster takes him down again.
Holding the tight. Holding the tight.
There's Tojo with that kendo stick. All right.
Now, what is this?
Disqualification. Disqualification on Tojo. Lancaster ducks out of the way of Tojo.
He hits Tojo for the ball.
Now, look out. Frankie, here come the Japanese team in.
Now he's getting what he deserves.
Now
he's getting exactly what he deserves.
It's four against one here. Lancaster not having a lot of friends just days ago. He was a member of the stud stable, so I don't know that he's going to find much help here. He finds himself in one of those unfortunate situations.
Well, hey, look what we have here.
Mason Dixon connection out to help him out.
Yip and yap.
Even it up a little bit. Lancaster going after P.Y. Chuhai. Tojo Yamamoto back it up now. Whoa, Hickerson. Look out. P.Y. Chuhai knocked over the desk. Tojo. Look out with that kendo stick. They hammer Hickerson into the desk. Mason Dixon connection working on the Japanese team meanwhile. Tojo hands Hickerson the kendo stick. The match goes to Frankie Lancaster by disqualification. But then all of this has occurred after the match is over.
They're getting exactly what they deserve,
they
Dave
not.
Brown. Exactly.
The Japanese are out here interfering. Tojo and his guys just can't stand it. They get beat in
look
there
at this.
And look
at
they
this.
Do.
There he goes with a chair. You
I'll tell you what, we're going to try to sort it out. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back. We'll get him out of here. Come
look
on.
Look at this.
Go ahead, take the break. We'll be back. Championship wrestling and more of it to come next week. I tell you, a couple of matches of special interest here today. One of them I think we need to mention is where Frankie the Thumper Lancaster got his grudge match right here on TV with P.Y. Chuhai, Phil Hickerson, and beat him. Now, he beat him by disqualification, but he had him going pretty good, and Tojo Yamamoto came in. I think Tojo knew that his man was about to get beat, and he came in with that kendo stick. Referee saw him. Disqualified him immediately.
That man wasn't about to get beat. I swear, you can't see the same matches I do, evidently, Dave Brown.
Well, I guarantee you this. Frankie Lancaster has himself a victory. Looks mighty good on his record against P.Y. Chuhai. Even though he did beat him by disqualification, he was beaten up on him pretty good before the match ended. And also, brand new CWA heavyweight title holder today. Young man who is,
Just one minute. He did not win that belt, and I am tired of you saying he won the belt.
He did win the belt.
Oh,
he
no.
won the belt from Dutch Mantell. Mantell was out here. Robert Fuller has had a horrible week. His stud stable falling apart. He signed Dutch Mantell to be a member of the stud stable. And then Mantell should be mad at Fuller because Fuller said, yeah, we're going to book this title match. Jeff Jarrett wants the title match. Go ahead. We'll book it here today. So it was booked. The promotion said, let's do it. Title match. Jeff Jarrett wins the belt fair and square in the middle of the ring. And Dutch Mantell is now the ex-CWA heavyweight champion.
Next week.
Speaking of ex-champions, Robert Fuller, as I said, has had a tough week. This is one of the CWA tag team belts. Jimmy Golden, Fuller's longtime partner, finally said, I have had enough of you, Fuller, in the stud stable. I'm leaving. I will not defend the belt anymore. As a result, the CWA has declared the belts are vacant, and there will be a super one-night tournament to determine who gets to wear the CWA tag team titles. As we said during one of the matches, these belts have some of the greatest history of wrestling anywhere. Some of the people that have held the old Southern tag belts, which are now the CWA tag team belts, going all the way back to Don and Al Green, Jerry Lawler, a pole holder, many, many years ago. And all...